What's up, everybody? This is Whiskey in the Six. I'm Rob. Today, I'm reviewing Deanston 10-year-old cask strength PX sherry finish. Grab my water bottle here and taste it neat, and then add a touch of water. So this particular expression was aged for 8 years in ex-bourbon barrels. After 8 years, they carefully selected some PX sherry butts and transferred the whiskey into those for 2 full years to make this natural color, unchill filtered, beautiful expression. This one goes for about $80 at the LCBO, which, for those of you who know the dealings of the LCBO, $80 for a cask strength whiskey is actually very good. It's bottled at 57.5%, so it's up there in ABV, and that's only because it's a little bit younger than other cask strength whiskeys that tend to be a bit lower. Okay, so the longer it's in the barrel, in Scotland in particular, the more the alcohol percentage reduces. Whereas in Kentucky, for example, it's the opposite effect. Because of the heat, the water in the alcohol, in the whiskey, evaporates faster than the actual alcohol. So, pretty interesting contrast there. You'll see that like a 20-year-old cask strength scotch tends to be in the low 50s, sometimes high 40s, all right? And that's straight out of the barrel. So this one's 57.5, not excessive, but still pretty high. Bourbon people are probably thinking that's not so bad because they're used to something in the 60s or 65, even higher sometimes. This one's got an incredible nose. Right, it's got all that chocolate that you're familiar with when you think of PX sherry aged whiskey. A very strong hazelnut type note. Honestly, this one kind of smells like Nutella. Sweet. Hints of raisin. Beautiful nose. Ridiculously sweet on the palate. I've had this for probably about a month now. The first couple drams were sweet. It's increased in sweetness probably by 50%. It's a super sweet dram. I think I might have to pick up a second bottle of this because it's really, really good stuff. And you don't need water, which is the scary part. I encourage you to take small sips of this one and try not to add some water until about halfway through. Take a few sips, enjoy it a little bit, and then add some water just for your liver's sake, if anything. I'm gonna add a touch just to give you the contrast, but not too much because, wow, that was a little more. Added a little bit more than I wanted to there. Again, this is 57.5%, so the amount that I added probably brings this in like the 45 range, 46 range. Still a beautiful nose. A little bit more grassy once water is added. You lose a little bit of that chocolate note that actually is beautiful and something you would want to keep, I think. On the palate. becomes super buttery, mouth filling, incredibly sweet, no heat whatsoever with water. Man. Like I said, this is $80 at the LCBO. And it just goes to show you what cask selection has to do with a quality whiskey. If you really care about the casks that you choose for your whiskey, you're gonna have an incredible whiskey. And honestly, this, it's gonna be very tough for me not to give this an A+. It's actually, on the palate, even a touch better with water. Because it's just chocolate and, like I said, Nutella earlier. It's creamy. It has this beautiful buttery texture. I'm trying to find something wrong with this, guys, but I really can't. I mean, yes, it's 10 years old. Yes, you can tell it's a bit younger. Would you be able to tell the difference between this and an 18-year-old scotch? I don't know. It's really good. One more sip and then I'll give it a mark. I had it marked down as an A. I'm gonna keep it at an A. I think the one shortcoming of this one is the finish. For a cask strength whiskey, you expect it to be a little bit longer. But honestly, it's as close to an A+ as it gets. So 89, give or take 2 marks. That's really close to an A+. As I continue down this bottle, it's gonna be hard for me to not bump that mark up. I'm gonna say it's an 89 for now though, because I've tried some pretty incredible whiskey and I'm having a little bit of a moment with this whiskey right now. But honestly, it's incredible. I'm gonna give it an A+. I don't care. It's a 90 at least. That's right. That's my first A+. Well, that's not true, because my Octomore is only 5 years old and that got an A+ as well. So that's one of the younger, affordable whiskeys that you can pick up, and in my opinion is an A+. If it's too strong for you, that's even better, because it'll go a long way. It's 57.5%. That means you can add a little bit of water, pour yourself a smaller dram, add some water, and it'll go even longer. All right. That's an A+. I can't deny that. It would be difficult for me to say otherwise. And I'm very curious to hear what other people have to say about it. I know one of my consistent viewers recommended this bottle to me, and he loves it. And I'm in agreement. It's an incredible whiskey. So, A+. You guys can check me out on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. This Friday, I will be on the Scotch for Dummies channel, because they're going to be doing a live event. It's going to be a long live event. It's going to be about four or five hours, something like that. They're going to be at a whiskey, like a whiskey festival, basically a whiskey event. And they're going live with myself, with the Scotch Test Dummies, and Aquavite Roy. So I highly recommend you guys check that out. Tune in on Friday. I'll probably be around 7:30 Eastern, or sorry, I'm assuming that's their time, so it would be 8:30 Eastern time for me. Check us out. If you guys don't have the time to watch us live, then you'll be able to check it out later, but I highly encourage you check us out live, because they're gonna have a whole bunch of ambassadors, a bunch of reviewers, and it's gonna be a really, really cool event, okay? So Scotch for Dummies, If you haven't subscribed to them already, do it now because they're really cool guys. Cheers.